This video explains the background of how networking works in VRChat. If you want step-by-step instructions, check out the next video in the series. The concepts we'll explore in this video are variables, events, and ownership. Variables are containers for values, like a number, a set of colors, or a 3D position. Events are things that happen at a moment in time. For a scoreboard in a game, you might use a variable to store and update user scores, and an event to trigger fireworks for the winner. Objects in a world are local by default. That means that an object you pick up only moves for you. I don't get to see any changes. To synchronize the object, we need to tell VRChat that we want it to be a networked object. The first player who opens a world becomes the owner of all the networked objects. They can make changes to those objects, and the changes will be sent to everyone else. When you change the owner of an object, the new owner is in charge of the network data, and everyone else will listen for their changes. For this demo, we're using two special components: VRC pickup, which makes an object pickuppable and gives ownership to whoever grabs it, and we also use VRC object sync, which automatically syncs the object. So the simplest networked object you can make is a game object with VRC pickup to manage ownership and object sync to manage its data. Object sync will update an object's position, rotation, scale, and some physics properties. To sync other data, we need variables. For this example, we'll sync a slider. Now, I just want you to understand generally how this works. Our next video will go over how to actually build it in Udon. To sync the slider, we need to get its number value. This will be a number with a decimal point between 0 and 1. We'll make a variable. We can call it whatever we want. I'll call it slider value. And we set its type to float. We set up our slider to update this variable slider value whenever the slider is moved. For the owner, this is straightforward. When the slider moves, we get its new value and update our variable. This value will be packed up and sent to everyone else. That's called serialization. When it's received and unpacked by the other players, that's deserialization. So the owner moves the slider and sets the new value of slider value. VRChat will update slider value on the other players and then trigger an event called on deserialization on those players. When this event is triggered, they use slider value to update the position of the slider and the text in the readout. Okay, let's talk about events. Events happen and then they're gone. Unlike variables, which can only be updated by the owner of an object, anyone can call an event on an object. You can choose to send it to everyone or just to the owner of that object. For example, when I use this bubble gun, it sends an event to everyone to fire particles and spin its barrel. But once the event has fired, it's gone. What happens to people who join your world after some synchronization has happened? It's straightforward. Variables will be updated, events will not. When someone joins your world, they get the latest data and then the on deserialization event fires for them, for every networked object in the world. So they can run whatever program you have that fires from on deserialization and makes use of that data. Events, however, are gone. There's no reason for them to fire off the bubble particles when I've already thrown the gun away. Let's recap. Sync is done through variables and events. For variables, the owner of a networked object updates a variable, sends that data to all the other players who deserialize it. Anyone who enters a world gets the latest data to deserialize. For events, anyone can send a network event. It will either be received by the owner or by everyone in the world at that time. You can download a package which has the objects I demonstrated in the scene to try them for yourself. Have fun!